Hey, Most Amazing Top 10 family, I'm your host, Chade Raina. Welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. Digging around the dirt, finding old stuff. Some of it's cool, some of it's just old dinosaur poop. That's a real thing, just so you know. And some of it will ruin your life and scar your brain, making you a zombie and then bringing back the Dark Lord to this world to end all of humanity. Now, there might not be stuff that's that bad on today's list of top 10 archaeological discoveries straight out of your nightmares, but I bet you there will be some stuff that will make you second guess that anthropology degree. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Also, stick around for the whole list because I'm going to be doing some more pet shoutouts, which you guys love so much. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. At number 10, we have a pit full of arms. I don't think anything nice was ever found at the bottom of a pit. No one has gone to the base of a pit and found a PlayStation 5 with The Last of Us 3. It's almost always death, and this pit was no different. Some archaeologists in France came across a super deep pit. Like, if you fell in it, you would die 100%. Of the time. There's no way you're sticking that landing, not at all. So it makes sense that at the bottom of this pit, they found a bunch of skeletons from people who had been thrown into the pit. It was Death Pit, which is the name of the metal band I'm going to start after this video. Now, the thing that was so shocking about the bodies that were thrown into this pit of despair is what happened to the bodies before they were thrown into the pit. All the people had their arms chopped off and their skulls bashed in. Like, you're already going to throw the people to their death. Why would you mutilate their bodies before you chuck them in? The pit was literally layered. At the bottom layer was all arms, and the top layer was all bodies that had their heads smashed in. Like some sort of sick cake. Who would do such a thing? Well, the bodies were dated back to 4000 BC, so their motivations were very unknown, but it was probably just because they were cavemen. At number 9, we have the black sarcophagus. This is my problem with archaeologists. They're always digging around, finding things that maybe don't want to be found. Maybe something was buried 20 feet underground because it was never supposed to be opened ever again. Like the black sarcophagus. This thing was dug up in 2018, and right away people were saying that this thing was cursed. It got posted all over the internet, and it spread around like a mid-tier meme. Like, you know, the kind of meme that lasts for like 2 or 3 weeks at best. Like, when you look at it, you just blow air out of your nose and then move on. Like, that kind of meme. It wasn't great. Well, everyone said that this thing was going to rain fire from the sky if it was ever opened. I mean, and it does look like something pulled right out of a movie. And guess what the archaeologists did anyways? They opened it. Oh, this creepy box that might kill everyone? Let's just open it just in case. There might be a boat in there, who knows? Now, nothing can be connected directly to the sarcophagus, but remember how much people were complaining about 2019 and saying a bunch of bad stuff happened? Coincidence? I think not. At number 8, we have head on your chest. How do you want to die? This might be something you want to pick because it's the only thing in life that you can guarantee. I want to die on TV saying something cool, so my death quote gets turned into a meme like 100 times. It's like all over the internet. I want my death to be turned into like an Infinity War level meme, like a huge level meme. Also, side note, Thanos did nothing wrong. But I don't think that these guys got to pick their death. There were some weird bodies that were discovered in England. They were dated back to the 14th century. The weird thing about these bodies is that they were all buried laying flat with their heads propped up on their chest like they were holding a basketball, which means that someone was chopping off these dudes' heads before they sent them into the ground. Not the most fun way to die, but at least they got to keep their head. They didn't start kicking it around like a soccer ball or something. If I was one of the guys in charge, I would bury them, but I would switch their heads around so the person finding them would have to do a match game to match up the right heads. At number 7, we have puzzle time. Did you know that if you throw a person's body into a bog and it's cold enough, it will help preserve the body? Well, I didn't know this either until I started making this list. Well, there was a dude in Scotland who found some bodies that had been buried for hundreds of years, but it seemed like before they were buried, someone had been doing some bog therapy on them to keep them in a preserved state. This is slightly creepy, but let's kick it up a notch. There were two bodies found, a man and a woman. Both of their bodies were very strange. There were limbs and body parts that seemed to be too large for their frame, almost like it was some sort of mutation. Everyone was confused. Well, thanks to the magic of DNA, the people digging up these bodies were able to find out that this happened because someone had been taking different body parts from several dead bodies and assembling them to make some sort of creation. Very creepy. And some of the mismatched body parts were hundreds of years older than the others. How did someone find bodies that were hundreds of years old, and why did they try to attach them to other people's bodies? That's something we will never know. At number 6, we have the cheese. Usually people digging around in Egypt want to find a gold tomb that is filled with guys wrapped in toilet paper. But every now and again you find something a little more strange. A tomb in Egypt had a little snack inside waiting to be dug up. Why would this be on a list of scary things? Well, because the cheese was over 3,000 years old and was packed with some unknown bacteria. If someone was dumb enough to bite into this cheese, they could unleash a plague that could wipe out humanity as we know it. Death would sweep through the world and ravage every last man, woman, and child. There would be nowhere on earth that you would be able to be safe from the terrors of this bloody cheese. People would become cheese monsters, like all the creatures that walk around in The Last of Us, except they would smell like Parmesan. Well, either that or the dude would just get the worst diarrhea of his life, like poop water for like 8 weeks straight or something. Really, either is possible when you weigh it out. At number five, we have Wolverine-ish. For this next one, it really depends on what part of the story you look at to whether or not this will be a nightmare to you. So in Italy, a body was found from someone who seemed to be from the 8th century. He was a pretty old dude, and this guy had his arm chopped off right above the elbow. Now that is the scary part, someone amputating part of your body. No one wants to have their arm chopped off at any joint. But in place of his missing forearm was a big knife. This guy had a stump, and then at the end of it was an engineered prosthetic that had a knife on it. He had a knife hand, which I think is cool as hell. This guy could be walking around in the year 800 punch stabbing people like a G. Punch stab, punch stab, punch stab, punch stab, punch stab. This guy's cool as hell. But I can understand why that would scare people, because you never want to be on the bad end of a guy punch stabbing you. At number four, we have a gnawing sensation. The body of a Roman woman had a little surprise in her nether regions. And let me tell you, it was not a sexy one. Not everything below the belt gets hot. In fact, this was one of the most gross things that has ever been discovered, and I never want to come in contact with anything like this ever again. Well, this lady was found with a tumor in her pelvis. What was crazy about it is that the tumor was caused by an infected egg inside of her womb. This would cause the egg to partially develop, and the tumor had teeth in it. Ugh. That sounds like something that should be pulled out of a horror movie. The living tumor that has come to take over your planet. You will all be slaves to this toothy monster. Because this lady happened to die before x-rays were even a concept, there's a good chance she had no idea what dental danger was inside her body. At number three, we have vampires. As much as we complain about the world, it's nice to know that things used to be way worse. Like maybe you don't like your job, or maybe you were stuck in traffic, or maybe even got dumped. But at least you weren't tortured to death because people thought you were a vampire. A tomb in Bulgaria uncovered a man from the 1200s who seemed to be horribly murdered, most likely by people who thought he was some sort of vampiric monster. It seemed that he was forced into a grave, and then someone took a bladed weapon to his leg and hacked it off. And because the only way to kill a vampire is to stab it through its heart, they hammered a steel stake through this dude's chest, pinning him to his own grave. Joke's on them, you have to use a wooden stake. So this guy rose from the dead to seek revenge. Just kidding, he died for sure. He was for sure dead. At number two, we have Pit of Sorrow. Something this list has taught me is that things have definitely got nicer over time. I know the world isn't perfect, but this next point shows how commonplace brutality used to be. There was a pit found in Austria that had an entire tribe of people in it. 94 bodies were found, and they were all dated back to 5200 BC. Now, how did all these people from the tribe die in the same place? Well, they were attacked, and from the looks of it, it seemed like the opposing tribe came in to wipe them all out. Everyone in the pit had their head cracked open, and then had their knees and legs snapped, and some of them had arrowheads lodged in their backs. The thing that sent this over the edge is that 27 of the 94 bodies were children. This tribe, the attacking tribe, made sure that everyone was dead except for women. There were only two female bodies found in the gravesite, so this most likely means that the women were all taken into slavery. Alright, for the number one spot, we have some hidden tunnels that were dug up in Chavín-Huántar in Peru. The tunnels zigzagged into all sorts of hidden rooms that could have been used as some sort of hiding place or escape route from invading tribes. But it seemed that the main thing that the tunnels were used for was sacrificing people in rituals. Several bodies were discovered that were dismembered in all sorts of strange ways. They would be strapped down to altars and then mutilated to death. Some of them had their heads chopped off, and others seemed to have their hearts pulled out of their chest while they were still alive. Imagine someone putting a bag over your head in the middle of the night and then dragging you to some horrible underground lair and then cutting your still beating heart out of your chest. That's one hell of a Friday night. All right, everyone, that is our list. Thank you all so much for tuning in. And as promised, I'm going to be doing some more pet shoutouts. Remember, if you want me to shout out your pet, you can hit me up on Instagram. I pick new pets every day, so if you don't get picked one day, message back another day. And without taking any longer, let's shout out some pets. First, we have Jason. That dude is super cool. I like his style. Very colorful lizard. Daniel sent in a picture of Pee-wee. He's a little fur baby. I want to snug him so much. Then we have Heather, who sent in a picture of her sleeping cat. Look at him just having a big old snooze. So cute. Tara sent in her fur baby Oscar. He's got a kind of sassy look to him. I like it. Sabrina sent in glamour shots of Dino. That lizard looks like it should be in a movie. And finally, Max sent in a picture of her curious fur baby. I like how it's just like inspecting the camera. It's really getting in there. All right, everyone, that is our list. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Until next time, I've been Jade Arena, and I'm gonna stay out of some tombs. I don't need to be in no tombs. I'm tombless. We'll be right back.